pretty simple, actually. An urban environment, and if you start growing agriculture, the two terms come together, and we're happy to be forming the term urban agriculture. Essentially, what it means is a lot of people now today are beginning to live in the cities, and food's getting transported into the city. We're trying to do away with all the mess, with all the fossil fuel wastage, and we're trying to get you fresh fruit and food right in your backyard. Urban production and agriculture makes it urban agriculture.
So in terms of the Plantagon itself, how does it actually work?
Okay, Plantagon per se is a very simple arithmetic. We use 1/10 of the land space and we go vertical on space. The moment you do that, we need a technology to ensure the plants grow in a height, which is exactly why it's vertical agriculture. We have a composite structure that's a helix that makes sure the plants are planted right on top and they keep coming down as they mature. It's a closed structure, that means everything is controlled environment. The product is optimum and organic if required. Essentially, anything that goes up in dense environments will make agriculture profitable, and that's what vertical agriculture is all about. We have a structure which is a standalone, and we also have a structure which can be wrapped around existing commercial buildings. So what I'm saying is you could have your beautiful mega towers in Abu Dhabi and Dubai, and we could wrap them around with a green greenhouse and still make lots of green business out of it. Right in the middle of the city, probably right in the heart of your city.
Fantastic. So in terms of food security, obviously, this is a major concern in our world today.
That's right.
How does Plantagon, how does this vertical agriculture factor into that?
The core objective of Plantagon when we started about 10 years ago was to understand the dynamics of change. Today, 69% of the world's population lives in a city. 20 years from today, that's 80% of the world's population. The other problem is that 80% of the agricultural land is already used up, and we have only 20% left. Population is growing, land is not. Essentially, we need to devise an innovation whereby agriculture and farming can be bought inside a city. That's essentially where urban agriculture for Plantagon comes into picture. The other thing that happens is a lot of fossil fuel, a lot of, wastage in logistics is attributed to deteriorating nutrition value. If you club the two problems together, that's food security and food safety, this is a one unique solution. The only hassle with the solution is it's an innovation that it's waiting for this time to get accepted.
I guess that's the next question. In terms of the financial challenges when it comes to this kind of technology, if it is out there, if it's available, it seems like an easy solution. Why are we not seeing more widespread adoption?
Perfect. It's been in the market for the last 4 years, and we are evolving as an organization ourselves with better innovations. However, in terms of return on investment, which is the prime category for finance, in less than 6 years, however great your investment would be, you would have your return. At the end of the day, an ROI or a financial capability is measured by the market to be able to sell to. I'm talking about a city, which is 1 million+ people, willing to afford organic fruits and food. So where's the question of non-viability?
I mean, does it have a very high startup cost? I mean, where does the hesitation come from?
The hesitation comes from understanding that this is an innovation. Agriculture is a still traditional business. This is a technology-driven innovation, and that's a psychological and a mental block to start with. Secondly, no innovation is cheap when it's not commoditized yet. However, this is not too expensive either, right? In comparison to any other greenhouse, this is probably a few bucks more, but the effects and the after effects are extremely advantageous. So in the long term, this is obviously the thing to be in. Evidently, we think that regions in the tropical zone would require them far more than regions elsewhere, and that's why we're here in Abu Dhabi to try and see if we can talk to somebody who's prospective enough to understand an innovation.
I guess that's obviously my next follow-on question. We are here in Abu Dhabi in the United Arab Emirates.
Right.
What kind of interest have you seen from the region? Is anyone in particular you're talking to? What kind of progress in that regard?
Right. Before I go there, let me tell you where a Plantagon already exists. It's there today under construction in Linköping in Sweden. We're doing an academic plus an institution in Singapore. We're working in Hyderabad, India. We're also talking of a lot of other global cities today. As far as the Gulf is concerned, it's a strange coincidence for us. The late ruler of Dubai, Sheikh Rashid Al Maktoum, and our chairman we're owned by Native Americans, the Red Indian Native Americans, by the Onondaga Nation. The chief of the clan, Oren Lyons, and the late ruler of Dubai have been very good friends. They've had conversation on this subject 8 years ago, 8 or 9 years ago actually. We're hoping that we can renew that conversation further, speak to the present ruler of Dubai and explain to him that here's a technology we were trying to make for 8 years, we're ready, and we want to take it up.
What kind of timetable, I guess, you're looking for in terms of that? When would you hope to launch?
Technically, it's launched. We're waiting for somebody who can sit up and talk to us. For example, the Abu Dhabi Municipal Department. We're talking to them tomorrow. And we're trying to talk to a couple of people in Bahrain and in Doha, Qatar. Essentially, what's going to happen is people now understand that this innovation is no longer just an innovation. It is ready to be commercialized. It's ready to be put right in the middle of a marketplace. It has a lot of socio-political equations that have to be dealt with at a local level. So we want to start the dialogue as soon as possible because we're ready when you're ready.